It's Mark Mulgrew with another great show. With lots of chat and music to go. Put your feet up and just relax with Black Diamond Radio.
So put your feet up and just relax. Good chat and good music. And this afternoon, I am talking to Susan Mirrey. Good afternoon, Susan.
Good afternoon, Mark.
Welcome to Black Diamond Land, as I like to call it, or Midlothian.
Thank you very much.
Now, we're going to have a wee talk about your career in music.
Absolutely.
Because you are you're a singer.
I know.
You've been treading the boards for a number of years.
Absolutely.
And it all started back. Tell us where it all started back in the 1970s, I believe.
In the 70s, yeah. I'd always been a keen singer. When I was about 6 or 7, realised, oh, this is what I want to do. Very musical family. And I think I was about maybe 13, 14, and I started following adverts and things for bands, and I joined a punk band.
A punk band?
Yes, and we done a lot of original stuff. Excellent musicians.
What was the band called?
This was called Electrolux.
Okay.
And obviously this was in like my area, Kirkcaldy. The other guys come from Leven, but we teamed up and had some really good gigs. We covered a Skids gig one night. There was a few venues that a lot of local bands were playing back then. So that was really my thing then, my big thing then. And from there, it just kind of, just kind of move on to other things. But that's where it all started. I was a punk.
You were a punk.
A young punk.
Back in the 1970s, well, I was only just young myself, I've got
Absolutely.
To say, at the time. But it took you, you played down in London and stuff as well, so you travelled
about a bit with the
band, yeah?
Well, it wasn't until after I left Electrolux that I decided to go down to London. I was about maybe 16, I left school, because I wanted to pursue music, and I went to Edinburgh for a wee while, and was working with the guys that owned a recording studio.
Mm-hmm.
So I got a wee bit insight to how recording worked and things, and then went down to London when I was 17, and eventually got a job with Mecca. Well, it was a big band in Ilford Pally.
Right.
And that would be early 80s. That would be about 1980 then. And that was fab. That was great. So I loved that. That was for a couple of years.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was probably the highlight of my career.
Right.
Then I think it was, it was a busy, busy place. There was a DJ playing in between your sets. Very professional. And I learned a lot there as well about professionalism and
learning the craft.
Absolutely, yeah. Very disciplined.
Mm-hmm.
Your everything had to be bang, bang, bang. You had certain songs to learn, chart material, all the chart material coming in, and your keys couldn't be changed, so you had to have a good range, vocal range then. Luckily, I was young enough, so my voice was still quite fresh then.
I suppose, and back in the 80s as well, Susan, that was when, there was music on every night, there was such a thriving music scene.
It was, yeah. Well, we, as the resident band, we done Friday, Saturday, Sunday and Monday, and I'm sure they had other things on through the week. If there was ever anything else, then we would be required, mm-hmm. that we would be required to do. It was easy just to be called up, like whether it was a Tuesday or Wednesday. But with it being Mecca, you were involved. We'd done some gigs for, like, when they had the Miss Great Britain competition, things like that, in the big hotels in London.
Yep.
Because we were named the Mecca's best band for I think it was 2 years in a row when I was there, so we did get all the good gigs, so it was great. You got to meet
It was good stuff. And then, well, we're going to talk. We've got three segments that we're going to do. But you took a break. You took a break from music for a while.
I did, yeah.
And that was obviously to have your family. And,
yeah, you know, yeah.
And have a real job.
I know. A real job. Oh, dear. I had a while off and I was going back and forward. And you're always doing wee bits and pieces of favours. And always getting up and singing with, you know, if you were at functions, if there was a band playing, we, you know, get Susan up to sing a couple of songs.
Can we get her up for a song, yeah, son?
So
everybody in the band's going on.
Always, I know. They're always the same songs. Is it the same song? And yeah, Simply the Best and Wind Beneath My Wings, I think, was that was the time. So I was going up. But I decided to do some fitness training. I'd always been interested in exercise and fitness. So I did a course and got a job in a local gym, and I was there for like 10 years teaching classes. So that kept me busy, as I say, while the kids were until they were up and running
and causing mayhem at school and
stuff.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Absolutely. Right, we've got three different tracks of yours that we're going to play today.
Yes.
The first track was done by the Supremes.
It was, yeah. Love the 60s stuff, yeah.
Love the 60s stuff. This is The Happening.
Hey, light, look at me. I was sure, felt secure, until love took a deep turn.